Hello, my name is Mark Sadkowski, and I'm from the Interactive Media Lab Dresden at the Technische Universität Dresden in Germany. I'm going to present the joint work of Wolfgang Büschel, Raimund Daxelt, and me about our experiences with user evaluation in augmented reality. User evaluation, especially with regard to user experience, is of great importance for AR research, and prior work already identified different challenges and needs. For example, those are the need for more in the wild and long-term user experience studies, challenges while collecting and analyzing study data, as well as the need for new evaluation methods fitted to user experiences in AR. In our own prior and current work, we also encountered recurring challenges, which are connected to the input capabilities in AR, participant-experimental communication, and the complexity of AR systems and setups. We will now present those challenges in more detail and show possible approaches to tackle those problems, which can also in return introduce other issues as well. First, study participants are often quite inexperienced with AR head-mounted displays. In combination with the often still error-prone input techniques of AR, this can lead to an increased number of input errors. To solve this, it is possible to reduce the set of interactions needed in a study, use alternative input devices, or even let the participants answer orally. As an example, you can see in the video on the right how we used the Microsoft Clicker as an easy-to-use input modality, which participants were quite familiar with, as it could be used like a mouse button. Second, since the AR devices only allow to let the person that wear the device see the virtual content, it is hard to communicate with the participants about what they see or do. Additional devices or applications can be introduced to let the experimenter see or at least track what the participant is doing. For example, the HoloLens device portal can be used to stream the view of the participant. However, this is quite taxing to the hardware and can reduce the overall performance of the system. Further, the experimenter could also wear a HoloLens, which in return leads to our third challenge. With the introduction of more devices, for example several HoloLenses, the overall study application becomes more complex and more costly to develop. This can also lead to more technical problems as seen in the video to the right. Further, if we want to conduct real-world experiments, infrastructure for such systems is needed. For this, emulators could be used, while already developed frameworks or libraries could reduce development costs in different areas. For example, here you can see the U2Vis library developed at our lab, which can provide different information visualizations for AR applications. This concludes my short presentation. I thank you for your attention, and I'm open for questions.